Hi, welcome back. I'm Chris Sikora, and I'm going to step you through Exercise 20, SOLIDWORKS 2020. Now, Exercise 20 has to deal with building that desk that you see there. Now, we're not going to build it, all the parts and such like that. What this exercise is more about is file management and setting up a design library so that you could reuse parts over and over again. Now, the design library is nothing more than really just the Windows file management system. So in Explorer, when you make folders, you can actually create a collection of subfolders inside of the main folder and utilize that. And that's exactly what we're going to do. So what you're going to need to do now is I would go to your browser and go to the Vertanu1.com. So V is in Victor, E-R, T is in Tom, A, N is in Nancy, UX1.com. Don't forget the one. And go to Part Files. And you're looking for the exercise 20 parts. I would just go ahead and click on that. Hit download. And open with Explorer. Now, depending upon your browser, it might show up here and you might have to click up there to bring it up. But you'll see that there's this collection of parts here. Now, what you can do is you could just, I would recommend, because it's a subfolder, go to extract all and then locate a place you'd like it. Like, I'm going to go to browse and I'm going to drop these into my SOLIDWORKS basics folder under documents, SOLIDWORKS basics, and I'm going to hit select folder, and then it should list this for the directory. Hit extract. So we're gonna have to remember that. I wonder if we could actually copy and paste it. Let's try. All right, so I've got them all in there. Oh, drat, it didn't create a subfolder. Okay, that's not what I was hoping for. I'm going to cancel out of that one. Let's try that again. Let's go to extract all, and let's just, we're gonna drop it on the desktop, I would recommend. Let's just so we don't have any issues. And once you get in there, let's go ahead and name a folder. Actually, let's create a folder here. Right click, new folder, and we're going to call this desk parts, and then double click on it. Go ahead, select folder, and there we go. Okay, we could hit extract. All right, so now they're extracted. We could close that out. Let's go into SOLIDWORKS. So once you're in SOLIDWORKS, go to the gear up here at the top, which is the options menu, and find the file locations. Now here's the show folders for, and we're looking for the design library, and you should see it listed right there. Now go to add, and now we could go to the desktop and just click one time on desk parts and hit select folder. Now imagine you could do this from anywhere. I just put it on the desktop for ease of use. Okay, and hit OK. And would you like to make the changes? Yes. Okay, I got some interesting options there. Let's see if it's showing up now. And let's go to the design library. And there's our desk parts folder. As you click on these, you'll see there's the bolts, casters, desktop, dowels, legs, and ribs. If you wanted to create additional folders, you just create them in Windows in Explorer. And then you could just drop the parts in there and categorize them and do what you need with them. We're going to start off with a new assembly. We're going to see how it works now when we drop them in. Okay, now I'm going to cancel out of this and cancel out of begin assembly. And instead, let's save the assembly and just save it on your desktop. That's fine. And let's go ahead and we're going to name this E20. Hit save. Okay, now as we go to the design library, we could select, let's bring in our desktop first. So click on desktops. Grab the desktop and drag it right in. And you could add additional ones if you want. Just hit escape. And I'm going to lighten this up a little bit. I'm going to go to plain white. It's a little bit better. It's a cherry wood top, and it's just very like orange. In fact, I'm going to turn off Real View Graphics, hoping that that helps. Okay. All right, so we have the desktop there. Now, here's the thing. The desktop shows up on, not on the plane that we had hoped for here. There's our right plane, there's our top, and there's our front. So it's actually on the front. And so if we were to hit the space bar and go to isometric, our desk is going to be laying on its side. Is that a big deal? No, you could actually flip it over and flip it around. In fact, I think I'll show that to you instead of rotating the part around. I'll show you how to save this later, right side up. Okay, flip it around the bottom side here. And now we're going to drop in some additional parts. So go over to the design library. And we're looking for dowels. Zoom up as close as you can here. Let's just verify from our training guide what belongs where. So it looks like the dowels are on the outside and the fastening bolts are on the inside. And you see there's one here. Theoretically, we could just mirror these if we want, or it's not bad practice just to put them in individually. But zoom up really close. And I'll grab the dowel and drag it. Now you might see it actually goes ahead and you can drop this. Now there it says hold the Alt key for some information there, which now it's not doing it. But anyway, I'm going to drop that right in. And you can see it's going to go with concentric. We can hit the green check. And we have more. Let's go ahead and add one over here too. Click on that. Hit the green check. Let's go over here. Add it over on this side. Green check. And then over here. Green check. Now you can hit escape. So we got the dowels, but they're not locked in. And now you might be wondering how we did that. And that's with something that's called a SmartMate. So like if I double click on it, actually right click on this and open it. Okay, it's an older version. It's actually called a mate reference. And we're going to learn how to put those in. And essentially you could select certain surfaces that you would want to make sure that they're inserted with the mate reference. And you could always, if you forget where it's located, you could type in the help area up at the top there, mate reference, and mate properties manager tab. Let's see, mate references. All right, and from here we would be able to find where we could activate it. It gives you all the information on it. And I want to show you how to put one in. There it is. It's under reference geometry, insert reference geometry, and mate reference. Can you tell I didn't practice this ahead of time? Sorry. I wrote the book on this, but I haven't done this lesson in about a year. Okay, so it's under insert mate reference. And basically what it does, it brings up, you could add up to three references in one part. So you could have a primary reference and you could select like a surface and say, I want that to be tangent, coincident, parallel, or concentric. And then same with the other two. This one, I only added the one mate reference. And we're just going to keep it simple. It's already in there. But you just select it, hit the green check, and then you save it. So I'm going to hold Control Tab. We're not going to go through any further than that and how to use them, but they are great for using this type of thing. Okay, let's go to Mate. And we want to mate this surface so it sticks out a specific height. So click on that surface and then click over on this and set it to a half inch and then select this face here. All right, and now we could go to coincidence, select that face. Oh, that's concentric, sorry. Coincidence up here. Select that face and get all of them the same height. And I believe we don't have to hit the green check mark on almost. There we go. And just add it. Let's see, did that one take? No, okay, so let's get that last one in there. Select that face. And this face. Make those coincident. All right, why did that not accept it? Let's try that one more time. Okay. I think we're good. My apologies on that. All right, now let's get in the fastening bolt. Let's take a look at the fastening bolt here under the library, bolts, and zoom up to this one right over here. Now grab the fastening bolt, and you'll see this one doesn't have a mate reference. So you could always just drag it back in. Second here. Hold the alt. Let's see. Just drop that over there. Oops. Okay, that opened it up for us. Perfect. It's not exactly what I wanted to do, but if that didn't just hit escape and go over to this area here and double click on fastening bolt, and it'll open it up. When you double click, they open up. All right, now to add a mate reference, let's do that again. Let's go to insert, reference geometry, and we're going to go ahead and select mate reference. And we'll just do a primary. We can select this face right here, hit the green check. Okay, and just make sure the mate reference is there, and we've got it. Now, control tab. Let's go back there. We might need to save that actually. Just a second. Let's just make sure we save it. Go up to save. And now let's go back. All right. Control tab. And let's try it now. Grab the fastening bolt, drag it in. Now, so to flip this, the tab key on the keyboard will flip it inside or out as you drag it in. So make sure that's sticking out like this, and then release it. Hit the green check, and hit escape. Now what we're going to do with this is we want this to be level to the surface. So hover over the surface, hold the Alt key, click, and drag to this gray surface, holding Alt and the mouse button. Release the mouse button first, and then just hit the green check, and so it's level. Let's go over here and do the same. Now, let's just, we'll add the second one, and then I want to show how to mirror across. Now, we've done these things before, but let's try it one more time here. Okay, fastening bolt, drag it over. Does anyone remember the key for flipping it? Tab. Get it right there. Hit the green check. Hit escape. And now you can go ahead and Alt, drag this surface to that surface. Hit the green check. All right, now, you might want to do patterns sometimes. So if we wanted to pattern those two over here, we could. We could have actually patterned them all. Just showing you different techniques here. So if you want to pattern those fastening bolts, control select both fastening bolts, go to, let's see here. Linear pattern component, hit the little arrow underneath there and find mirror components. Now you'll see the mirror plane. We need to select. So hit the little arrow. Now in this case, as we hover over this, we see that none of those planes for the assembly are any good to us. So let's try the desktop. Hit the little arrow to the left of desktop. And here we could actually see we can use the desktop. Just be aware though, if that design changes, everything will update with that desktop. But if you ever swap out the desktop, you might get little messages saying that it can't find the reference. So that's why I typically like to use the assembly planes for something like this, if you can, but it's not available, so that's okay. Hit this little right plane here, and that's in the desktop. Hit next, and we can see a preview. They're in place. We don't need to make any new ones there. We could hit the green check mark because it's right side up, so we're in good shape, and you can see them over there now. All right, let's bring in a leg now. So go back over here, find the leg. You'll see there's a mirror leg, but don't use the mirror leg. I want to show you how to create one if you don't have one. So we'll drag this over here. Just want one. And what I would recommend doing is make sure, see these little holes right here? Those have to be aligned to these fastening bolts because there's going to be little twist nuts in there. We don't have those. I never made them, but I think you guys who've done IKEA furniture before know what it looks like. All right, first of all, let's get this surface onto this surface. So rotate around till you can see it. Hold Alt, drag this face here, and then remember Tab. Oh, drag. Didn't want that. Okay, you could release Alt and then hit Tab, and it looks like it's working now. All right, hit the green check. Now, we could use the standard mates that we've all learned in the earlier classes. I'm just showing you some quick ways of getting about doing this. All right, now let's zoom over here and see that hole there. We want to drag that to this. So, again, with the Alt key, drag it over and lock it in. See, it should go concentric. Let's do one more over here. Alt, drag to that surface. Hit the green check. Okay, looking pretty good there. Let's get the casters in. So go back over here and let's double click on caster, double click on it instead. We want to open it up and see if we can add the mate reference. We can see there's no mate reference. We would see a folder if it were there. So let's get a mate reference on here. Select this face, go to insert, reference geometry, mate reference. And hit the green check. Control Tab back. Keep hitting Control Tab until you get back to the assembly. There it is. And now let's go over here. Oh, I forgot to save. Darn it. Let's go back to the caster. Make sure you save it. If you don't save it, it might not work. All right, now Control Tab back. And let's give that a try. Grab the caster. Drag it right in there. It looks like it's good. Hit the green check. We don't even have to hit the tab key. Let's get one in over here. Okay, and let's drag that up. And now what we want to do, we'll just use a standard mate here. This face to that rubber grommet edge there. Okay. And do the same over here. Now we're going to have to pull that one out. This face. Oops, went too far to that face right there. All right, let's get around the side and we're going to get the screws in there. Hit the green check on mate, so it's not in there anymore. And I'll just go back over here and we'll find the bolts again. And we can see this one doesn't have a mate reference either. Just drop two in and hit escape. Let's try a little trick. Alt and drag. Get it in there. Remember the tab key, flip it. And then click on this, Alt and drag to that surface. Okay, click here, Alt and drag to this surface. And then click on that surface, Alt and drag to that face. Feel free again to add the mates if you're having difficulty with the Alt and drag. It's more of an advanced thing to do that. So just be aware. All right, now we're going to bring in the next part, which, I have to go insert components. We're going to go over here to the ribs. Grab the rib, drag it in. Just one. And now what I'm going to do here is I'm going to select this edge here and go to mate and select this lower edge here. Now I'm going to flip it right here is the flip mate alignment and hit the green check. Now I can rotate that up. And let's get around this side so we can see that hole. There it is. Okay, so we're in the mate tool. Actually, I'm just going to go ahead and select this face here. to the bolt. Now we want to go ahead and mirror over these parts. Now be aware this would not mirror over properly because it's not symmetric on both sides. So we're going to have to make a new one. So let's go to mirror components underneath linear component pattern. The mirror plane, once again, we'll use that right plane inside the desktop. And then the component to mirror. Go ahead and select this, the leg, and the two casters. And select the two bolts on the outside. Let's hit next. All right. Everything looks pretty good with the exception of the leg itself. Now the leg, if you look here, it's hard to see, but actually what's happening, unfortunately, oh, is it actually, no. Unfortunately, there's an intersection there. You can't see it. Oh yeah, here we go. See the bolts are on this side, the bolt holes, and the bolt holes need to be over on that side. So we need to make a mirrored version of that. And right here we have create opposite hand version. So select the leg and click on create opposite hand version. And there it goes. Notice the holes disappeared because now they're over there. You could hit next and it's going to ask, do you want to rename the leg? And or it'll, by default, we'll just add a prefix of it's the mirrored version. That's fine. Hit next. And transversal bodies, surfaces. You can just hit the green check mark. There's a lot of options there. And hit yes. Okay, so the colors don't match exactly, but you could go back in and add your own materials. Now let's hit our space bar and go to isometric. Now this is where we have that dilemma where it's on its side when we go to the orientation that we're interested in. So like the front view shows the top of the desk. Here's what you do. Hit your space bar, and you could turn this off, the view selector, for just a moment. Now we're in front view orientation. And what we want to do is we want to change that to where this is the top. So go over to update, let's see, update standard views, select this as the top. And just hit yes. Now go to isometric. And there it is. So you can flip the desk around to your liking. You could even rotate it the other way. I mean, you could do a lot of different things with that. And forever now, if you go to front, there we go. That's it. There we are. All right. And we go to right, isometric. That wasn't right. That was the back. Okay. Now we're going to go ahead and drop this into a drawing and explode it. Well, we'll explode it first. So let's save it. And then go to exploded view. Click on the desktop first, drag that up. Okay. And hit done. Now we want to grab these. Drag that up. And you can right click to apply that. Oh, we should have done all of them. Oh well. Then we'll get these over here. Oops, and I didn't want that. I should have, let's remove that one. Okay, I want to hit done first. Now click on this one, drag it out partially. And then hit done to get this side. And then make sure you hit done. There is that right mouse button option, which I keep forgetting to hit. And done. All right, now for the explode, here's what we need to do. Explode lines. So hit the green check. Now underneath Explode View, go to Explode Line Sketch. Select, like we'll just do one here, select that. This, and then that. Okay, hit the green check. And basically that's, you just keep adding those to make that. And so you get all the exploded lines to show how it's assembled. And that concludes exercise 20.